Scenes from McLaughlin Parade Field this week. Crews brought down the installation flagpole. The project to replace it should be completed by January. Hello and welcome to Meade Week. I'm Brian Spann. Also this week, highlights from this year's Army-Navy game. The Exchange has a new food option and a look at this year's Veterans Day observance. These stories and more, but first, the Fort Meade Community Covenant represents the ongoing commitment between Fort Meade and the surrounding community. This week, the Community Covenant Council came together for the fourth time to formally sign the agreement. Maryland Congressman Dutch Ruppersberger and John Sarbanes headlined the signing party.
Now, when government joins forces with business partners and community groups, we can achieve so much more. And that is why I'm so grateful that we have this council, which has empowered the Fort Meade community to fill in the gaps that the government can't fill.
The covenant that we're re-signing today is a kind of formal way of memorializing the commitment that we all share. But we don't need that to have the kind of connective tissue that we've built. It's just a way of re-upping periodically to show that we're not taking anything for granted when it comes to these amazing partnerships.
Since its inception, the covenant is signed by each new garrison commander.
Perhaps it's just over-optimism, but I truly believe that there is no problem that exists that we, as a community, cannot overcome when we work together as a team.
In other news, the 2019 Fall Housing Resident Satisfaction Survey starts November 12th. A link to the anonymous online survey will be sent to the primary email address listed in your resident file. It's your opportunity to let the command know how we can do better. Please note this survey is different from the work order and move-in survey you may receive at any time. Elsewhere, the Fort Meade Exchange held the official grand opening of the newest addition to the food court, the Muscle Maker Grill. The addition is meant to offer another healthy option.
And it fits right in with the Army's holistic and healthy lifestyle initiative. We wanted to provide a healthy, good for you option, an additional one to our soldiers and airmen, you know, basically to fuel our warriors, in addition to some of the other choices. You know, as you mentioned, it's all about choices, and this is just another option for our customers.
Fort Meade site is the fifth exchange location for the Muscle Maker Grill. In other news, the McGill Training Center hosted this year's Veterans Day observance. This year's guest speaker was Jerry Bell, a Navy retiree. She is now the managing editor of O Dark 30 and co-author of It's My Country Too, Women's Military Stories from the American Revolution to Afghanistan. At this week's observance, she talked about the most essential women in the world, the women of World War II.
They were serving under fire, they were prisoners of war, they were nurses, they were gunnery officers, they flew airplanes, they drove vehicles and maintained them. And they were, as the recruiting poster said, the most essential women in the world.
We'll have more on this year's observance in the next edition of our award-winning newspaper, The Sound Off. Meanwhile, in sports news, the 20th annual Fort Meade Army-Navy flag football game on Mullins Field this week ended with Army owning a third straight win and five out of the last six. The final score this year, Army 24, Navy 12.
So, Navy wants the ball.
Army got the scoring started about 8.5 minutes into the game on this short pass to the front pylon. Army led 6-0 after a failed two-point try. Navy came back to tie the score with 2:49 left in the first half. Navy's two-point attempt also failed, leaving the score even at 6. The tie score didn't last long. On the very next play, Army deep in its own territory, connected on a bomb down the left sideline. And in a blink of an eye, Army had the lead back at 12-6. And that's how it would stay at the end of the first half. Army extended their lead about midway through the second half on a play that looked pretty much like their first score. Neither team had much success on extra point attempts, but Army was cruising at this point 18-6. At the 5:20 mark, another Army touchdown all but sealed the game at 24-6. Navy got a consolation score on the very last play of the game to make the final score 24-12 for Army. The only thing left to do was celebrate the three-peat.
1, 2, 3! Army Horse!
One final reminder from the 902nd Military Intelligence Group and the Fort Meade Equal Opportunity Office. They invite you to the 2019 National American Indian Heritage Month observance on Wednesday, November 20th at 11:30 at Club Meade. This year's guest speaker is Grammy-nominated artist Don Avery. And that's Meade Week for this week. I'm Brian Spann. For everyone at Meade TV and the Fort Meade Public Affairs Office, have a great weekend and a great Meade Week.